Hello, welcome to
Resident Evil Revelations.
Always wanted to do that. We're playing this game on the PlayStation 3 first, as of, well, I do have it on the PlayStation 4, but I just can't find it. When I do find it, we'll play it on there. I am not a fan of the PlayStation 3 version. I like the one that's newer. Well, I've decided this out. Resident Evil Revelations and 4, I'll just do it when I want to. Operation Raccoon City, I'm waiting until I'm doing. Saving that for the Halloween week, let's say. My second chance of one, then. It's just loading. Loading. There we are. I've played this before, but Jill and Parker. Parker's only one of those, so.
Hey, Jill.
Last time I played this, I was scared as hell. Yeah, I'm alright. I like the controls better. This feels stiff. Controls feel wonky.
Yeah, the stench.
It's been abandoned for a while.
Signs
blood coming from the ducts.
Oh no, the faulty controls. It has control of its own, it has.
It's not working.
Does she speak all the time? I'm not going to get much far with this control scheme. Yeah, sorry about that, it's just the controls weird on the PlayStation 3, now on the PlayStation 4. Okay, shall we continue? We shall.
Shorted out. The power still works here. Parker, give me a hand here.
Sure, no problem.
Cutscene.
I got something. I think it's a gun.
Now what?
Give me a sec.
Not Chris. Missing crew.
This is not good. Where are you, Chris?
Flashback time.
This sunny and idyllic Mediterranean coast was the site of one of the world's greatest structures. It took a full 11 years to finish constructing the world's first Aquapolis, the floating city of Terra Grigia. A sustainable metropolis operating on a massive solar energy matrix and equipped with the latest green technologies. Never before had solar energy been used to supply power to an entire city. But in 2004, Veltro, a terrorist group opposing the city's development, launched a bioterrorist attack. They not only released a virus, but also several creatures, known as bioorganic weapons, further complicating the situation. This launched one of the worst tragedies the world has ever seen. The FBC, the world's leading counter-bioterror organization operating under the auspices of the U.S., was called in to direct efforts to contain the attack. The BSAA, a counter-bioterror NGO, which operates independently of the interests of any one country, went in as observers to assist the FBC. Realizing the need for immediate and decisive action, Supreme Local Headquarters issued the order to use the city's solar energy matrix on itself. Media outlets around the world began to refer to the incident as the Terra Grigia Panic. Following the incident, the FBC announced it has successfully disbanded the terrorist group called Veltro. It is now 2005, and a sense of calm and security is finally returning to the people. But, as you can see, the lost city of Terra Grigia remains inaccessible, a silent and potent symbol of the threat that bioterror poses for people around the world.
Sad. Very sad.
You are.
What's wrong? You don't normally join the fair.
Well, my doctor told me I need exercise. I assume you both know that the FBC has cordoned off the entire area. However, in the past few weeks, a number of mysterious carcasses have washed up.
I guess the FBC couldn't cover up a mess this big, huh?
Anyone who knows what happened here is going to put two and two together.
And that's why I've sent the BSAA in to investigate. Did you pick up your new equipment from Quinn?
Yeah. Genesis something. Is that its name?
You didn't bother to read the manual, did you?
No. I brought it with me, just in case.
I hope you read quickly, because you're gonna need it on your mission.
I want it.
I'm sad that Parker dies. I really like this guy. He only appeared in like a reference to the second game of this and maybe in another Resident Evil game. And also, there was this first boss thing. I like Parker. And Clancy.
Ah, look at this mess. The Genesis requires a decent sample size to get an accurate reading. Scan the carcasses on the beach and send me your data.
Parker.
Have a look at this.
I'm getting something from inside it.
Careful now.
Don't worry. I've done this before. I've got something. What is this? If it's an engineered mutation, this could prove a link.
I'll run some tests on this. Continue with the investigation.
there. That's what got me doing. Ready?
Now to kill something.
Collected enough samples.
Good. Get them to me ASAP. Get that sample data to me. There you are. Nice work.
No doubt about it. These corpses show signs of viral infection.
And I bet it's no coincidence they came through the FBC's blockade.
Well, we did all we can. Now, we wait for the results to come back from HQ. Huh? It's the emergency line. Yeah, it's me. What? Yes, that's fine. I'll take it from here. We'll have to speed things up. Starting now. Uh-huh. Good. Get to it. Jill, Parker, you two are still on the case.
What happened?
We lost contact with Chris and Jessica.
When?
Oh. We're not certain. I've sent their last known coordinates to your terminals.
The signal was lost over the ocean. I thought they were in the mountains chasing Veltra. But judging from their position, they must be...
on a ship. I'll go back to HQ, take charge of the search and rescue. You two will be my eyes out there.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
things got to Chris and Jessica?
I hope not.
Hey, no one's saying Chris is dead.
All right, then let's find him already. I'll check it out. Copy that. I'll radio you if I pick up Chris's trail. This scene has a lot of similarities to the corpses on the beach.
We could have 40 on the beach.
Survivor. The BOW's got her, though.
Who was she?
I'm still trying to piece that together. Parker, I couldn't find anything out on the woman, but I did find a key.
Let's try it out. I'll meet you in the crisis room. See you there.
Not Chris. So, wait, we're going to definitely end it on there, I guess, for episode one. In the next game, they did it on DLC, they did, believe it or not. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.